Cells are alive, as you can see in this video of a single cell protist. In order to stay alive, cells have organelles that work together. These organelles are similar to our own organs that work together to keep us alive. Welcome to MooMooMath and Science and the Organelles of a Cell. To begin with, there are two major types of cells. Prokaryotes, which are found in the kingdom Archaea and bacteria, and eukaryotes, which are found in fungi, animals, protists, and plants. Prokaryotes have no nucleus or membrane-bound organelles. I remember this by saying pro rhymes with no for no nucleus. Eukaryotic cells contain a nucleus and has membrane-bound organelles. Let's take a look at the major organelles of a eukaryotic cells and their functions. Up first is the cell membrane. The cell membrane is a membrane that surrounds the cell. This membrane allows certain things to enter and exit the cell. Think of it as a protective barrier. Cytoplasm is a jelly-like fluid that fills up the cell. Think of the water that fills up a water balloon. Without cytoplasm, the cell would be deflated and materials would not be able to pass easily from one organelle to another. In addition, there are important molecules dissolved in the cytoplasm. You will find enzymes, glucose, amino acids, and several more. And these are used to help keep the cell working properly. The cytoskeleton, as the name implies, is the skeleton of the cell. The cytoskeleton of a cell is a network of filaments running throughout the cell. These filaments have different jobs in the cell. They help provide support, much like your skeleton. They also provide tracks or highways for the movements of vesicles and other objects. They help pull the chromosomes apart during mitosis, and sometimes even help the cells move. Ribosomes are tiny protein factories. They receive instructions from the DNA and converts this information into a chain of amino acids, which becomes a protein. Each type of protein has a different chain of amino acids. Next, we have the nucleus, and it's the location of the genetic material and DNA of a cell. It sends out instructions to other organelles, much like the ribosomes. The rough endoplasmic reticulum, or rough ER, is involved in protein production and transporting proteins. It is the location of many ribosomes, which makes it look rough. It takes these proteins created by the ribosomes, and it sometimes may modify these proteins and then packages them into a vesicle and sends it out to the Golgi apparatus. Smooth ER, which is smooth because it does not have ribosomes, produces lipids, which are fats, plus helps to detoxify the cell. The mitochondria, it's the powerhouse of the cell. It creates this energy by taking glucose plus oxygen and makes the energy molecule ATP. Vacuoles are organelles that store materials like water and other materials. You gotta have storage. Lysosomes, which are created at the Golgi apparatus, they contain enzymes that help break down waste materials and digest materials in the cell, like bacteria. Speaking of the Golgi apparatus modifies and sends out proteins and lipids into the cell. It receives these proteins, modifies them, tags them, and then sends them either into the cytoplasm or maybe to the cell membrane where they are released out of the cell. Now, chloroplasts, which are found only in plants and are the site of photosynthesis. At the chloroplast, carbon dioxide, water, and sunlight are combined to create sugar. And then the sugar is used at the mitochondria to produce energy. And another structure found only in plants at the cell wall. It is a rigid layer made of cellulose that surrounds the cell, the plant cell, and gives the plant cell structure. There we go, the organelles of a eukaryotic cell. Thanks for watching, and remember, kindness multiplies kindness. Be kind to someone today.